Hi friends, Daphnebakia with its wide green leaves and green stem will add a rich look to our gardens. It grows in soil very well as well as in water also. Many plants grow in water very well like pothos. Here I tried to grow the Daphnebakia plant in water, so I took a beaker. Wide mouth beaker are very suitable for this Daphnebakia propagation in water, and also some marbles or gravel to balance the plant. So this is the plant I have brought from the nursery. It got roots also. The roots which developed in soil are very strong. They are very dark in color, and they got some subroots also. Wide mouth beakers are very suitable for this Daphnebakia plants. But for pothos and other philodendron plants, we need to take a big container or glass container which has got a very small mouth. But for Daphnebakia, its beaker is most suitable. This is the day one. I have adjusted the plant with some gravel. Daphnebakia is a proven air purifier plant. It is a perfect indoor and semi-shade plant and needs indirect sunshine. It is also called as a dump cane. Please use gloves while handling this Daphnebakia plant because it contains calcium oxalate, which is a poisonous element in this plant. It's poisonous to human beings, especially children and pets. So keep this plant away from the reach of the children as well as the pets. Change the water in the container once in a week, and please take care of that water while throwing it away. Dispose the used water properly because it contains some toxins also. On the right side, this is the another Daphnebakia plant which I have put in water 6 days back. Now it's doing very well. Already small roots have started coming. And it's doing very well. While propagating any plant in water and while changing the water once in a week, please take care of those roots which come in water, because the roots which develop in water are very fragile and they will easily broken. Here I have already broken one root, so it's not good for the plant. So while handling the plant, we have to take care of these small tender roots. The roots which develop in water are different from the roots which develop in the soil. The roots in water are very thin in color and very fragile and very tender and easily can be broken. So while changing the water, don't take out the plant completely from the container. Just try to drain the water out and put new water, and drain it once or twice so that we can add new water into that one. So this is the seventh day of the plant Daphnebakia in water. Already leaves are coming. 2 to 3 new loose leaves are already came out, and I'm looking out for the roots at the bottom so that the plant can settle down in the water. Daphnebakia grows in soil very well. It requires dry soil, and water the plant once in 2 to 3 days. It does very well in soil. Thank you for watching. Hope you like this video. Share it, like it, or like it, share it. Thank you very much.